Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual classrooms. We are studying the chapter of aldehydes and ketones, carboxylic acids, in which in our last lecture we discussed about the nucleophilic addition reactions of aldehydes and ketones. The another chemical properties. Another chemical reactions of aldehydes and ketones that we want to study, that is particularly related to the reduction, oxidation, alpha hydrogen reactions like that. So today, after nucleophilic addition reaction, we are going to study today a second reaction, that is reduction of aldehydes and ketones. Reduction of aldehydes and ketones. Now when we are coming across the reduction of aldehydes and ketones, we are having it as a different reaction. One is termed as simple reduction. That reduction we are going to do it by using some simple reducing agents. We are going to specifically use it as an NaBH4 or one as an NaBH4, or you can also use it LiAlH4. These are the two reducing agents which will convert aldehydes and ketones into alcohols. Now in place of that, we are going to also have it as Wolff-Kirchner reduction reaction. This particular reaction we are going to use it as NH2 NH2 KOH, hydrazine plus KOH, that means in basic medium. Clemmensen reduction reaction, for this we are going to use it as ZnHgHCl, zinc amalgam. This particular reagent is known as zinc amalgam. That means we are going to come across three different reactions, right? First of all, we will study what happens when we are having it as a simple reduction, right? That means if we are having it as an aldehydes, and they are reacted with H2 in presence of NaBH4, as a reducing agent, then at that time what will happen? This component will get converted into primary alcohol. It will produce primary alcohol. Now in place of that, if you are having it as a ketone and the same reducing agents are used, then the compound gets converted into secondary alcohol. That means by the reduction reactions, we are getting it as an aldehyde converting into primary alcohols and ketones into secondary alcohols. If you remember, in our last lecture, we studied it one of the nucleophilic reaction of Grignard reagent. When Grignard reagent was reacted with formaldehyde, it produced primary alcohol, and other aldehyde produced secondary alcohols. Why? Here, with the help of reduction, maybe formaldehyde, maybe any other aldehyde, they are all getting converted into primary alcohols, right? So this can be as in one of the question also, write a different methods or write a different reagents that are used for preparation of primary alcohols from aldehydes, right? Or how to prepare primary and secondary alcohols from aldehydes, right? Okay, similarly, this reduction of ketones produce secondary alcohol, while in our Grignard nucleophilic addition reaction, ketone produced tertiary alcohol. So that can be a method, right? A different method for preparing secondary alcohol from ketones by using different reagents, different reagent. One we used it as an over there as Grignard reagent, here we are using as a reducing agent NaBH4, right? So this is a simple reduction. In the simple reduction, what we got it? Aldehyde got converted into primary and ketone got converted into secondary alcohol, right? Okay, second one, that is a Wolff-Kirchner reduction. For this, we are going to use it as an NH2NH2KOH. We are going to get it as an carbonyl group. It's reacting with NH2NH2 in presence of KOH. Again, before I go it for the product of this component, again you can recall it, nucleophilic addition reaction of ammonia and its derivatives. We wrote it as NH2NH2. We got it as an hydrazone, right? But remember, if the reaction was carried out in acidic medium, here you are doing the reaction in basic medium. So that difference of the medium also changes the product. Though the reactants and reagents are same, only the medium has been changed. Product is going to be changed. The product here we are going to get it as hydrocarbon. It's not only for the aldehyde, the ketone. If we are taking it as a ketone and if we are reacting with NH2NH2KOH, it's also going to give out N2H2O and the product is going to get converted into hydrocarbon. In short, you can say that your carbonyl group is converted into methylene group. In this reaction, your carbonyl group C double bond O, the oxygen is removed and hydrogen is added, and that is why it is termed as a reduction reaction. So this is particularly Wolff-Kirchner reaction, NH2NH2KOH, right? Okay, third reaction that we are having it, that is Clemmensian reduction. Now this reaction we are going to do it in acidic medium. Now see, we are having it as a different reagent. In my previous reaction I told us that if the reactant and reagent are same, but the medium was changed, product changed. Now this time what I am doing it is, reagent is different, reactant is there, but the medium is different. Here the reaction is carried out with H2. That means I am going it for same reduction only. Medium is changed, but my product is still same. Right? So that is very important for us, that it's not every time the condition that if the mediums are different, product will be different. Medium may be different, product may be same. Medium may be different, product may be different, right? So we can have it as a different type of reactions. During the reaction, we can get it as different type of products also, right? Same thing if we do it with the ketone also. Just check with the ketone also. We get it as, again over there also, as a hydrocarbon. So in this reaction also we are getting it as a carbonyl group getting converted into methylene group, right? So that is what the reduction reactions we are having it. Three different reduction reactions that we are having it, right? The next one we will be going through, oxidation of aldehydes and ketones. We saw the reduction. Next one will take it as oxidation of aldehydes and ketones. Now again, For this also, we are having it as an, which type of oxidizing agents are used, right? We are over having it as an strong oxidizing agent. And when we are using it as a strong oxidizing agent, both aldehydes and ketones goes for oxidation. But when we are using it as a weak oxidizing agents, specific oxidizing agent will take the either aldehydes or either ketones for the reactions. Right? So first of all, we will study about strong oxidizing agent. When we are talking about the strong oxidizing agent, immediately it comes in our mind. It's a KMnO4. Strong oxidizing agent means immediately in our mind we will be having it as an KMnO4. Now for this, if we are having it as an aldehyde reacted with KMnO4, it gets converted into acid. Aldehyde produces acids with same number of carbon atoms. Whatever the number of carbon atoms were there in the product reactant, same number of carbon atoms will be there in the product. Whereas in the ketones, when you take it as a KMnO4, it produces, dissociates itself into two. It will produce carboxylic acid with two different components. Right? If your both these R groups are having it as the same number of carbon atoms, you are going to get it as mixture of carboxylic acid. If you are having it as an, depending upon R and R dash, you are going to get it as an carboxylic acid. It's going to be divided into two parts. Let's see one of the example for aldehydes as well as ketone. For example, if I write it for CH3CHO with KMnO4. And I'm taking it as in two carbons. The product I'm going to get it is CH3COOH. But in place of that, if I'm taking it as in ketones, now this is having two R groups identical. But when you are going to go for the KMnO4, you are going to get it as CH3COOH plus HCOOH. Right? This HCOOH, it generally dissociates itself into H2O and CO2. Right? But it's going to, if it is a single carbon, if you are having it as a more than one carbon, CH3, CO, CH2, CH3, then by using KMnO4, it's going to produce CH3COOH plus CH3COOH. It's going to produce 2 moles of ethanoic acid. That means it dissociates itself into two parts, right? So ketones, they are going to produce mixtures of carboxylic acids by strong oxidizing agents, while aldehyde produces carboxylic acid having same number of carbon atoms. Now this was for the strong oxidizing agent. In place of that, if we are using it as a weak oxidizing agents, specifically we are having it as a number of the such type of weak oxidizing agents. But out of that, we are going to study not all of them. We are going to have it as in specifically only two of such type of acids. We are going to get it as two of such type of weak oxidizing agents. One will term it as Tollens reagent. The second one will term it as Fehling's reagent, which we are taking it specifically for aldehydes, and one for the haloform reaction, which will be shown generally by most of the second own ketones, right? There is a condition, we'll see it. So first of all, Tollens reagent. What is Tollens reagent? This Tollens reagent is written as AgNH3 twice plus OH minus. Right, this is also termed as ammonical silver nitrate. Ammonical silver hydroxide, right? Okay, now this is the name of the component. Now how this is going to react? Aldehydes reacts with 2 moles of Ag, NH3 twice, OH. It gets, on heating it, produces RCOOH plus 4 moles of NH3 plus 2Ag, which gets deposited on the inner side of the test tube. When you are having the glass and in the inner side it's been stuffed with a silver, it acts as a mirror. So it produces silver mirror. So this particular reaction is also termed as silver mirror test. This is also termed as silver mirror test, which reacts and produces silver mirror, right? Aldehydes gives this test. Aldehydes only give the test. Ketones does not react. That means you can use this particular reaction as a distinguished test for different aldehydes and ketones. A question can be there, how can you distinguish acetaldehyde from acetone? So it's a very simple, acetone does not give the test, aldehyde gives the test, and therefore we can identify the component whether it's an aldehyde or a ketone. That is the tolerance reagent, the one we did it. The second one we are having it. Felling test. Now, for this felling test, again, that we are having it as an in the solution, felling A plus felling B. We are having it as in two components. Felling A is specifically CuSO4, copper sulfate. Felling A means copper sulfate. While felling B, we are having it as an sodium potassium tartrate plus sodium hydroxide. Completely felling B is sodium potassium tartrate plus sodium hydroxide. Alone, this sodium potassium tartrate is known as Rochelle salt. If I am writing simply sodium potassium tartrate, it's a Rochelle salt. Sodium potassium tartrate dissolved in NaOH, that means mixed with NaOH, it produces felling B. And felling A is copper sulfate. Now, when you are getting it as an A plus B, then it produces CuO. Cupric oxide, where Cu is in plus 2 oxidation state. Copper is in plus 2 oxidation state. This component reacts with aldehyde. On heating it, it gets converted into COOH plus Cu2O, which produce red precipitate. Here Cu is in plus 1 oxidation state, right? It produces cupric oxide, red precipitate. So this test, again, aldehydes only reacts, ketones does not react. So again, this component can be also used as distinguished test for aldehydes and ketones. But again, this particular test is also more useful when you have been given of aliphatic and aromatic aldehydes. Aliphatic give the test, aromatic aldehyde does not react. For this, aromatic aldehydes also does not react. So that is an additional characteristic of the Felling test. Right? And the third one, where every time we are saying it that aldehyde reacts, ketone does not. Then where does the ketone reacts? So that is known as haloform reaction. That is NaOH plus H2. It gets converted into NaOx. So maybe NaOH plus H2 is indicated or NaOx is indicated. It's a one and the same. It's going it for the haloform reaction. While going it for the haloform, here your X can be Cl, Br, I. X can be Cl, Br, I. If I'm using Cl, it's a chloroform that will be produced. If I'm using Br, bromoform. If I'm using I, iodoform will be formed. Right? But condition. If carbonyl group is attached with CH3, then only it gives the reaction. See, the condition is you should need carbonyl group attached with CH3. That means you should have minimum this much group, then only the reaction is formed. So that is possible in 2-1 compounds. That is possible only in 2-1 compounds, or maybe ethanol. It is also having CH3, C double bond OH, so this group is present, ethanol. Similarly, ethanoic acid, it's also the same group. These are the exceptional components. As well as, at the same time, this is an oxidizing agent. So if you are having it as an 2-ol, they oxidize first of all. First of all, they convert themselves into 2-ol, because we know it that if we are having it as a secondary alcohol, it gets converted into ketone. And it will get converted into CH3CO group. And so the moment it gets converted into CH3CO group, it can give this. So these are exceptional. If you are having it as a 3-ol or 4-ol, any other ketone, they does not give the test. Specifically 2-ol, ethanol, ethanoic and 2-ol gives this test. Right? Let's see what is the reaction that is happening in it. The reaction we will be having it is, carbonyl group is having one CH3. We know it that there is something present over here. Maybe any other functional group. Let's take it as an R. Right? We'll take it as an R dash. We don't know what is it. Maybe OH, maybe H, maybe R group. Long chain carbon atoms. Right? We'll put it R dash as maybe H. Or maybe OH or maybe alkyl chain. It can any of it. If it is an H, it will get converted into aldehyde, ethanol. OH, it will get converted into carboxylic acid, that is ethanoic acid. And if it is an alkyl chain, it may be a 2-ol ketones. Right? This will react with NaOH plus X2. That is NaOX. It gets converted into R C double O N A. From here it breaks the chain it gets converted into RCOONa, and this compound, the CH3 group, it gets converted into CHX3 halophone, which is yellow color precipitates. It gets converted into yellow color precipitates, right? And this is a specific component. If I'm having CHX3S, CHI3, it is known as iodophone. CHBr3, bromophone. And if it becomes CHCl3, it becomes chloroform. Right? So these are all the oxidation reactions that we came across for aldehydes and ketones. Right? Today in our today's lecture, we studied two of the reactions. Though it is considered as only two, reduction oxidation, but we are having it as a number of reactions present in them. Like we saw simple oxidation, Wolff-Kishner, Clemmensen. For the oxidation, we saw Tollens, Felling, as well as halophone reactions, right? Just make it as a practice of all these reactions. Recall them, write it in your notebook, and we'll study in our next lecture the other chemical reactions of aldehydes and ketones. Thank you.